Why, hello everybody, and thanks for joining us today. This is Kyle Edward from This Is Drive, and today we're going to review the all-new 2018 Toyota Camry. Now, the Camry has been the best-selling car in America for the past 15 years, so it's obviously a very important car to the brand. It's one of their best-selling vehicles and a true American staple. Now, for this new model year, they've really completely redesigned the Camry, both on the exterior and interior. As well, as you can notice just looking at the car from the front here, you can just see the more aggressive, sporty styling look that they went for, and they definitely, you know, achieved that. They said that they wanted it to be really more of a driver focused car, something that exudes sportiness, and as you can see with the new look and roof line, you can definitely tell that that is the case. I particularly really like these wheels on this car. They fit very nicely, I feel like, with the rest of the design of the exterior. Lots of spokes, again, giving it a unique look, something that is inspiring. It's also worth noting that there are just really a ton of different color options, both on the exterior and interior, so you can really, you know, customize the Camry to, you know, your personal individual styling wants and needs. Now, it's also very interesting to me, though, is that the Camry is actually sold in more than 100 different countries. It's really the most popular mid-size sedan in the world and is a segment leader in many global markets where it's available. It was actually introduced in Japan in 1982, and it was the first mass-produced vehicle with a transverse engine layout. And really welcomed the combination of affordability with superior packaging quality and engineering. That's really what they've been going on for all that time, just to produce a vehicle that is slightly high caliber than its competitors, both from an engineering standpoint as well as a practicality standpoint, different features that are available for less money. Now, the Camry starts right now at about $23,000 and go all the way up to around $35,000 fully optioned. There are three different models available. From the powertrain perspective, you have the base engine, you have a V6, and of course the legendary hybrid model. The hybrid model is more powerful this time and creates better MPG. So that's definitely a win-win for them all the way around. But as you can see with the new profile here, it's sort of like the two-tone grille. So we have the front comes in nice and low, and then also it's separated there by the center logo. But let's go on, let's check it out inside here and see what the all-new Camry is like in the cabin.
Now, on the interior of the all-new Camry, they really just continue that unique design characteristic, and you can even see that here from the door panels, how they have molded this really nice soft leather material, again stitched right here, but you can see how it comes right down here from the metal door handle, and it just gives you off that kind of like the front end look of the car. Somewhat futuristic, yet very sporty styling as well, especially considering that we're in, you know, it's a standard full-size sedan. But I'd just also like to draw the attention to the new level of quality here in the interior of this Camry, especially from the previous model, which, you know, was a very standard sedan, right? But this new model, I mean, just the level of craftsmanship that we have in here is really just high quality. We have the nice use of real metal here, leather, stitching. It even comes around here to the front as well. Just looking again, we have this nice, look at how good this looks right here. I mean, it definitely doesn't look like we're in a, you know, standard full-size sedan. It definitely looks higher end, upper class. But, you know, again, we have this nice metal accent around the trim, as the trim stitching here, again, leather, just all that right here. And not to mention this unique design statement right here with this panel. Coming down here, we have our automatic headlights. Of course, we have traction control off, the camera button, which I'll get to in a minute, trunk release, and of course, fuel door. There's just a mini storage compartment here for anything that you might want. Just taking a quick look here, we have all of the windows are automatic. Lock and unlock, of course, and mirror adjustment right there. So yeah, it's nice that all of the windows are automatic. You can just one touch down all of them if you'd like, which is great. Then, you know, again, just looking here at the new interior, a really nice steering wheel compared to the outgoing model. This feels so much better, really soft leather. The design is nice as well. Good buttons, solid feel on the buttons. They just did, again, a good job just making it feel high quality. Again, it's a very soft steering wheel, and definitely feels like it belongs in this car. Now, moving over here to the center, we have this new media system in the center here. I'm not a huge fan of it, just because I feel like it lacks some information. For instance, I really like to know about the trip, but that's all right in the bottom right-hand corner. That's all we get for the trip is right there. So not exactly sure what they're thinking. It's very focused on these very large graphics here, showing all of the different safety features that we have. Again, a lot of those you can see there. Rear cross traffic alert, blind spot monitoring, parking assist, and pre-collision tire pressure as well. So it's graphically pleasing, but as far as functional, I mean, what am I going to do with this screen right here? There's really very little I'm looking at there. Fuel economy, averaging 20 miles to the gallon, showing that there. The speed is always visible in the upper right hand corner. You can choose to turn that off if you like. Would be nice to see that miles per hour, the speed front and center there versus just in the upper right hand corner, in my opinion. But you know, it is what it is, and maybe we'll see some improvements on that. Yeah, pretty standard gauge clusters, nothing too out of the ordinary there. Over here, we do have the laser-guided cruise control, which is fantastic. We have, of course, the lane departure warning buttons and all of that right there. The sound buttons are located on the bottom here. Same with over here. We have voice control as well. It is a push-to-start vehicle, as you can see by the button right there. But now, you know, sort of just looking again at the interior here as a whole, we just really see this very modern, futuristic-looking interior, but it's also very functional as well. And we have the all-new Toyota multimedia system, which is just worlds better than the old one. The old one was bad-looking, it was slow to respond, obnoxious, really terrible. But the new one, finally into the 21st century, looks so much better. Home screen right here. It's of course touch responsive, just really nice looking graphics, a good font. You can change the source, very quick to respond, and it just works really, really well. You can go into a bunch of different things there, for instance the phone, and of course the device would have to be, you know, connected, but you know, again, very easy to connect everything. All of the buttons, very, very good response time on that. Really appreciate it. But yeah, just, you know, a lot of good stuff there with the new system. Looks a lot better. Again, very functional. We have the buttons here, sound, tune. Scrolling down essentially here, we have the climate control buttons, dual zone, which is great. We can also control it too, right here manually, keeping the auto mode. But then you can see this really nice design point, which just sort of leads right down here. Really separates the driver from the passenger and gives the driver a nice cockpit feel to it, right? So it feels like everything's sort of focused at the driver from when you're sitting over here. Not to mention this really cool new interior piece right here. This looks really nice. And again, just nice quality, nice stitching. Looks really good. Flows right into the center console here. We have eco mode, normal mode, sport mode. They honestly don't make a ton of difference in this particular engine choice. Of course, heated seats. Auto hold. Pretty simple stuff for right there. But yeah, just as you can see, the interior is so much better than the previous outgoing model. The seats are cool. And we have this nice quilted look design. Very comfortable. And again, this looks worlds better. It's really an entirely different car. We have the full panel sunroof. And yeah, I think, again, they just did an outstanding job. Definitely one of the high points of the all-new Camry is this new interior. So now let's go ahead and take it for a spin. Now, before we get started driving today and going over some driving dynamics and just general thoughts and impressions on the car, I just want to go over a few specs with you guys first off, right? So the base engine in the Camry is a 2.5 liter four cylinder, creates 206 horsepower at 6,600 RPMs and 186 pound feet of torque at 5,000 RPMs. It gets around 28 miles to the gallon in the city and around 39 miles to the gallon on the highway. Obviously, not a lot of power output from the base four-cylinder. Gets the job done, but that's really about it. Just bare bones power supply.
I personally would opt for the larger V6, which is 3.5 liters, puts out 301 horsepower at 6,600 RPMs and 267 pound-feet of torque at 4,700 RPMs. Gets about 22 miles to the gallon in the city and around 32 miles to the gallon on the highway. Now, both are connected to the 8-speed automatic transmission, it's a good transmission. I have no complaints on it. Provides some crisp, smooth shifts, and it remains well tuned so that we can achieve maximum fuel economy on the highway. Now, before I really get into what I think about the all-new Camry and how it drives, I just want to note that when obviously you have a car like this that's been, you know, the number one selling vehicle in America for over 15 years, it's really important that when you come out with a new design that, you know, you don't mess anything up, right? Because people are creatures of habit, and they don't want anything to be changed too much. Otherwise, sometimes they don't like that. They might not like it, and then you may have built a better car altogether, but then if no one likes it, no one's buying it, then that doesn't really matter. So I think they did a good job when they did the full redesign of the Camry to keep a lot of things that, you know, people who were buying this car really appreciated and liked about it, while also incorporating some nice new things that could potentially draw in some new buyers, while also keeping it really updated and in almost a class-leading vehicle here. So one thing that I really like about this car is just how smooth the ride is and how connected the steering still is in the suspension. Really good for a car in this segment. Again, very smooth on the road, steering's very connected, nice handling dynamics, suspension's well-tuned. Now, I will say the base four-cylinder engine here, yeah, it's really just not enough power for my taste. Now, if you're in the city just doing a ton of city driving, that's all, and that should be fine. But, you know, if you're out, you know, sort of doing some varied driving on the highway, in the city, in the suburbs, definitely would personally opt for the larger V6 because, I mean, it's really not a lot of power that we're getting out of the four-cylinder. And also, you know, it can be a little bit noisy as well, especially under a heavy load, a lot of acceleration. It really kind of breaks through, and, well, it's not horrible. It definitely doesn't give you the refinement that I feel this car really does offer. Now, with that said, the all-new interior is absolutely stunning in my opinion. It's so fresh, very futuristic, high quality, really do love it. I would also say that it's probably one of the best in the segment currently, just around, you know, very similar to the Honda Accord, depending on, you know, what your styling and tastes are, probably two of the best interiors in the segment right now. Also, we have some, you know, class leading features. We have a heads up display, which I really do love. It's not very often you see that feature on the cars in the segment or price point, so I'm really happy to see that they were able to incorporate that feature on the all-new Toyota Camry. Now, the other thing that I can really, again, appreciate about this car are just, you know, all the different models that you can get. So there is the, of course, base four-cylinder, there's the V6, and there's a hybrid. All of them achieve very high fuel economy ratings. They all have that really good standard of quality and reliability that the Toyota brand has come to gain over many, many years. So, you know, I think a lot of people will really like this all-new, refreshed, redesigned car. And, you know, it does have... That's, you know, maxing out the power. I want to say it does have a little bit, but honestly, it really just doesn't have a ton, you know? Not a lot to give there. Under 200 horsepower on 180, you know, just not a lot, especially for a car of this size. It's front-wheel drive. That's really all you can get right now. And that's really all you've ever been able to get on this model, as far as I know. So I don't see anything changing there. And, you know, there... So you can get it to pop up into that next gear. It will, you know, take off a little bit, But again, at the end of the day, we are just lagging a little bit behind there in the power department. Now, that's not to say that other vehicles in this segment with the base engine are any better, because all the manufacturers are really trying to squeeze every MPG they can these days, and that can be achieved by obviously putting small four-cylinder engines into these full-size sedans, which don't make a ton of power. So Toyota's not the only one doing it. They're all doing it. Ford's doing it. Honda's doing it. Everyone's doing it. So it's not, exclusive to Toyota, but it's really, across the board. But yeah, overall thoughts of the driving dynamics. It's, a very quiet, refined car, very comfortable interior. The steering feel is really in tune with the road. Nice suspension. And of course, I do appreciate that they do offer the larger V6 engine. We look forward to getting my hands on that one in the future as well. But overall, it really does encompass everything that a Camry buyer is looking for, and that's a comfortable ride, good fuel economy, modest price point, and I really do again appreciate the new design. They really went off in a new direction, giving it more of a sporty look, sporty design, a better feel, higher quality interior. And I think that will be received very well by the consumers, and I know it's certainly been received well by a lot of journalists, and myself included. So that's all we have for you guys today. Hope you enjoyed this review of the all-new 2018 Toyota Camry.